Hello, everybody, Dazas here. It's very hot day today in Toronto, and I feel like it's a good idea to talk about cooling fans, which I tested a few weeks ago, but never had the chance to share with you my test results. Before I jump straight into my test results, and I'm happy to share with you my thoughts, as well as I'm happy to read your comments and your input on the subject, I'd like to clear one thing out of the way. It seems when I spoke about relatively abstract terms, for example, speaking about performance of dual radiator versus quad radiator, or how speed of fans affect temperatures in a loop, everybody have a nice discussion, became very civilized way. But as soon as I touch a brand name, or God forbid, I compare two brand names between each other, a lot of people lose it. We're getting into personal type of angry discussion, people call names, and I don't really want to tolerate on my channel. I'm okay to delete all bad comments, but I think it will be better if we all try to put ourselves in a mood, then we have a constructive discussion and try to make our rigs simply better. Leaving this aside, let's go into what I actually did. This test I wanted to make for a while. I always wanted to know if the true measurable difference between different models of the fans and how they affect radiator performance and loop temperature, if we use this model or that model. And for my test results, I chose things that was in my possession. And also I use some input from other guys, and we have five fans here, and I'd like to discuss with them, with you, a little bit about the models I selected for this particular test. First of all, we have a EK Vardar fan, which is a new fan that was relatively recently introduced by EK. It's first attempt of EK to make electronics. There always was on more things which is not really electronics, such as blocks and reservoirs and things like this. So it's the first electronic device from them, and it has a lot of press recently, so definitely was no way I could miss that fan into my roundup for radiators. And the model I'm using is F4, which is natively spins at speed 2200 RPM. Second fan in our lineup is a Gentle Typhoon, which is a perennial favorite for water cooling community on radiators and considered one of the better fans for water cooling applications specifically. It wasn't available for a little bit, but now it started coming back in variety of forms, such as simply OEM or under brand name such as Darkside. And the model we're going to use today is the AP60, which spins at speed of 2150 RPM natively. Our fan number three is Noctua F12 industrial version, and that fan I actually purchased myself out of my pocket because I got certain feedback from a number of my friends, also from you guys from other side of the screen, saying those fans, it's not bad at all, and a lot of people swear by them. So I spent $100 out of my pocket, and I get three pieces so I can test those. So this model number three, it spins natively at speed of 2000 RPM. Our contestant number four is Coolant's HBK. The model spins at speed 2600. I had a really good result for this fan in the past. This is the reason I chose it again. Another reason is this fan is very similar to its construction to a number of other generic fans with sleeve type of bearing. For example, Yaitloons or Xerillion fans has absolutely identical type of construction. So for all means and purposes, I think it wouldn't be too much stretch if you can apply results that we're getting for Coolant's fan to those models, and probably if you were looking for information on those fans, it's all very similar to what we get for Coolant's. And our last fan is a Jellied Wing. This is a generic fan with sleeve bearing as well. I think this wouldn't be also not too much stretch if you try to compare these fans with other generic fans such as Bitfinex or Corsair or any other generic fan on the market. They are not really engineered that much for water cooling purpose. They're more about flash appearance and not necessarily perform well, but they look cool, and if it's something that you're after, it could be a good choice. It's also, generic fans usually don't spin too fast, so our Jellied has maximum speed at 1500 RPM, which also allowed me to use it only in half of my tests. And now back to my test results. But before I jump into Celsius and decibels, let's talk about money a bit as well. I look up pricing for all these five models in USA market, and so I'll show you price in US dollars. It might be different from other countries, but you can check your pricing as well. But I hope the type of difference in pricing will be similar everywhere. It doesn't matter what kind of currency we're using. So let's look on the chart. We can see that Nokce is absolutely top leader in the terms of pricing, followed by Darkside AP60. And after that, we have a relatively similar pricing for Vardar and Jellied, and Kool's absolutely cheap type of fan, which is also reflects the fact that similar type of the models that I mentioned before, such as Yaetluns or Xirilians, they also cost similar type of cash. And keep in mind that we have to look back when we look into the test results, how things actually cost and if those results worth your money. First test was burning CPU only, and I slowed down on fans to the same type of speed and did a burn test for that, for CPU 100% utilization. To my very big surprise, I got absolutely identical numbers. So it doesn't matter what kind of fan you use, if your system is total overkill, such as a triple radiator with a single CPU and GPU do nothing basically, you can have whatever you want and it will have absolutely no difference. You can find dollar fan in a dollar store, and if you have enough radiators, it will be performed as $30 fan, which is kind of interesting subject and interesting result, but it was very, very, very interesting type of thing. And I actually, for that reason, I almost skipped try my test on 2000 RPM, because I said, hell, if at 1100 RPM I have the same numbers, it has to be probably the same number for 2000 RPM, just maybe a little bit, few degrees lower. But to my big surprise, when I run remaining four fans, because Jelly is out because of the speed limitation, at speed of 2000 RPM, I found out that in fact two fans give me a slightly better result than two other fans. And specifically, both Gentle Typhoon and Nocture gave me a little bit lower temperatures than Vardar and Coolants. My theory behind that is it seems that both GT and Nocture probably has a little bit better pressure characteristics, and that allows them to push air a little bit more efficient through the fins of radiator. That's only my explanation why we get it. And because the difference not like 1 degree, difference is almost 3 degrees, I would say that it's definitely something's here, because if could be fraction of degree, I wouldn't even bother, because I'm not in lab environment. But when we have a 3 degrees difference, it's actually beyond the margin of error. So that was really interesting, and that started bringing more of my attention towards Nocture, because I never use this fan. It's also awfully loud in my previous test, but I was really surprised it was absolutely on par with Gentle Typhoon, which is I always consider kind of the best choice for radiator specifically. So next test was trying to go back to speed of 1100 RPM, so we can bring Jellied back. But this time I was overclocking both of my GPUs and CPU, which is quite a serious type of infusion of heat in your system, and triple radiator is pretty much a bare minimum that I would personally recommend to anybody who running two GPUs and CPUs as a water cooled rig. The test results for this type of setup was even more interesting than the previous one. We got two of the same leaders again. Darkside AP16, Nocture F12 was head-to-head, fraction of degree doesn't really matter here. And there was still the best performing fans on my particular setup. But then it was followed by Coolants, then by Jellied, and finally by Vardar. This brings me to, I didn't really expect this by any means, so it prompted me to retest everything second time around just to make sure something didn't went wrong, and I just got kind of strange result, but I got pretty much the same thing one more time. So it took me extra couple days of work, but basically the result was consistent with that first type around. The second round was exactly the same. This brings me to conclusion that WireDAR is probably not the best fan when you're running them at low speed and also when you're really thermally stretching your system. So you're absolutely on everything at the limit. So you have minimum type of radiator setup, system very hot and stuff like this. There's some other models that probably give you much better results. It also supports my series of generic fans such as J-Lead or whatever other fancy schmancy fans you have on the market. They look cool, but if you're really milking for performance, it absolutely should be your last choice going around. And another thing that I would like to bring here is the coolants was just 2 degrees higher than the top of the park fans, but it also was 3 times more cheaper. So for anybody who really on tight budget and why you're losing on performance side, the cheap fans actually can deliver acceptable result and be pretty normal type of solution for you if you can't spend $100 on a fancy fan setup. So that's better to keep in mind as well. So that was pretty interesting and very unexpected, and but that's what I got here. And finally, the third test was exactly the same type of setup. We have both GPUs and CPU at 100% utilization, but with spin fans to 2000 RPMs, kicking out Jelly again, so we have only 4. The results I got was a little bit more pleasurable, so we can see that still I have AP60 and Nocturne was again head-to-head with better lowest temperatures, but my coolants and WireDAR numbers was next in the line, very similar again, but the difference was relatively minimal, so 58 degrees versus 56. So that brings me back again to my previous comment that WireDAR on a lower speed doesn't seem perform that well as they perform on a higher speed. So if when you're choosing WireDAR and maybe lower end models, not the best choice. So look for 1500 or the 1850 2000 RPM models and they perform just fine. But if you go to 1150 RPM model, you might have, 5 degrees more, which is not very cool in your system. Moving forward, let's talk a little bit about noise because it's also an important factor in rigs for people. Some people don't mind because they sit in their headsets all the time or they're just simply deaf, but there's a pretty large group of users who like to have a quiet rigs, like including myself. I'm editing video, I need to listen to whatever audio coming out of computer and everything, and I hate headset, so I just use speakers, so I prefer my rig to be rather quiet. So for me, for example, the noise characteristic is quite important. So I tested noise characteristic both for 2000 RPM and 1100 RPM, and I kept my measuring device 65 centimeters or about 25 inches away from computer, which is type of similar setup at my home, and hopefully it's also similar setup for other guys who using computer next to them when it sit right on the desk, not under. If under, it's obviously much further than 65 centimeters. So looking into numbers for 2000 RPM, my chart shows that, again, not a surprise that Nocturne is a quite loud fan, actually, but it was very interesting that it was similar to coolants, and WireDAR and DarkSight was on the lower side, with DarkSight AP60 was the lowest sound levels, and WireDAR was just a little bit two decibels up, which is pretty good in my opinion. Another thing that I'd like to notice here is that it seems that delta between Nocturne and other fans was a little bit lower than in my open air test that I had before. And the reason for that, I believe that they have this clever design with those rubber corners that actually make a difference. I think the fact that the fan was insulated from radiator, it's produced much lower noise level than other fans, so it's improved characteristics. And there's definitely something that I would like to look into much further. I would like to test fans different speeds and with and without noise cancellation gaskets and see how much actually louder or quieter the system will be if we use or don't use that, as well as in temperature differences, because we reduce leak of air from radiator. But that's a little bit off topic. Now, if we're looking to the noise levels of fans at 1100 RPMs, we now have five fans in the chart, and now we have yet another surprise. We can see the Noctua actually went on the second place for the noise level when it's slowed down, and 100% attributed to those rubber corners. That's absolutely that's the reason why the fan was so sounding good. It just simply because those rubber corners, they do make a difference, and the fan went straight in the second place. It was quieter than Wardar and quieter than the coolants and Jelly. So it was pretty interesting. I would never ever expect it, because after testing all those fans on open air, we have such a huge difference between, let's say, Noctua and anything else. It doesn't matter what speed it spins, but when I install it and we have those noise cancellation corners, they actually bring the numbers in line with everything else. So now you have it. It was quite interesting exercise. Probably was the most interesting test I did in a recent couple months, because for the rest I kind of had idea what I'm getting, and I mostly confirmed it. This test was total eye-opener for myself for a number of things, and I hope you also find the result interesting. Feel free to leave a comment and a suggestion for this test or whatever other test you would like me to recommend to perform. I actually will be away for a couple weeks for vacation, so I wouldn't be post too many videos till mid-July. But definitely coming back, I will be making more tests, and I have quite a few on my own list, which I will happy to perform for you and share with you my result. Thank you again for watching my channel and for supporting Dazmod Store. We'll see you soon with more videos.